have the thought clearly behind. Now, you might take up the consideration of group A, the most important group on the physical plane from the standpoint of creation and of objectivity, for they are the life of matter itself and the intelligence animating the forms of all that exists on the systemic physical. C, on the ascending arc, spirit asserts itself at the expense of the material. This is true of gods and of men. P.S.P.T.288. E. Man is therefore a compound of spirit and matter. F.E.2.45. F. In man the intelligence links the two. F.E.2.102.103. P. Note to S. 30. Compare S. T. 2. 394. THOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOTHOT cell of conscious intelligence is consciousness and understood by the intelligence. Each of the atomic subplanes in the solar system is closely interrelated with the others, and the seven atomic subplanes of all the planes form a unity and are essentially the cosmic physical plane as the term is. Occultly understood, the subplanes of which they are the originating source bear the same relationship to them as the six principles which the seven. Therefore, the genesis of Group A are the concentrated creative force of the subplanes, the origin of the objective side of physical manifestation, and the source of the seven principles. Created logos on the physical plane. Remember that in each scheme the creative impulse or will is the planetary logos of the scheme, who is truly creates his body of manifestation under the law, his dense physical planet, as man under the same law creates his physical body, or as the solar logos at the other end of the scales creates his body, a solar system. This has a definite and esoteric bearing upon the subject under discussion, and the essential differences between the heavenly energies and manifestation can be seen in their schemes, and therefore in the types of devas through whom they function, and out of whose essence their form is made.
Their nature.
atomic matter of our planet circulating in deep substance. This will materially affect certain types of humanity more than others, according to their ray and nature, and this effect will demonstrate in 14 ES E 2 579 to 582. cosmic ether. The brain Adi, the first cosmic ether. The cosmic mental plane, beyond which it is unnecessary for us to go. It will be noted by the careful student that these planes might be located in connection with the three. 660 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. As demonstrating two types of force, first, a force which tends to differentiation such as on the mental plane, the plane of inherent separation, and on the physical plane, the plane of actual separation. Secondly, a force which tends to unity, such as on the astral plane, and on the plane of essential harmony, the Buddhic plane. It must be remembered that we are considering force as it flows through, or permeates, Jiva substance. A hint as to the truth lies in the fact that at present the astral body of man is positive to the physical plane, negative to the mental, and positive to the Buddhic plane. As evolution proceeds, the astral body will become positive to the mental, and thus prove incapable of being swayed by thought currents, and the separated processes of that plane, and negative to the Buddhic plane, are receptive to the forces from that plane. When it has attained equilibrium, and the forces are evenly balanced, the astral body should become the transmitter from the Buddhic plane, the fourth cosmic ether, via the gaseous, to the dense physical plane. This thought should be studied in connection with the burning of the etheric web of the planet, thus illumination may come. Literally, there is no such illusion on the astral plane as we find on the mental or on the physical plane. On both those planes, we have a division into two, the mental plane being divided into higher and lower, rupa and arupa, concrete and abstract, and the physical plane into the etheric levels and the dense subplanes. There is, therefore, a correspondence between these two. The reason for this apparent division, considering the question apart from the states of consciousness of a human being, is due to the stage of development of the great devas who embody the plane, who ends to live, and who manifests through it as a man. Manifests through his body. Varuna, the lord of the astral plane, has achieved a more unified consciousness role than his brother does. THOUGHTANDFIRELEMENTALS 661. The mental and physical plane. light which the creates itself behind form of every time. It should never be forgotten that the matter aspect is found on all planes, also that forms are ever to be found, until the solar ring has not as transcended and the local escapes from this present limitation. Owing to this, the devas of the astral plane assume a very important place in the three worlds. Previously, we considered them in a fivefold aspect, dividing them into five groups. At this point, we will limit our consideration to the relationship of self-conscious units such as man and the planetary logos to this given substance. A great distinction exists between man and his prototype, a heavenly man. The astral plane plays a very real part in the evolution of man, having a close connection with one of his principles. Astral matter and vibration is one of the controlling factors in the lives of the great majority of people. To the heavenly man, astral matter corresponds to the liquid portion in the physical body of man, and is for him therefore no principle. The astral plane is man's principal battleground in the area of his most intense field of sensation. Mental sensation, esoterically understood, is for him as yet only a possibility. The astral body is the seat of man's most violent vibration, and these vibrations are a sole cause of his physical plane activity. If man only realized this, the devas of the astral plane at present very largely control what he does and says, and his goal of evolution is immediate goodness to liberate himself from their control in order that he, the real leader or thinker, may be the dominating influence. To be explicit, and thus to illustrate this point, the little elemental lives which form the body of the emotion and the positive. Like many evolutionary diva whose true similarity of vibration is linked to any particular man and who gives you